Hello students and friends, welcome back to my session on PLC in 21 days. We are on day 6. In today's session, we will see about something about counter, inline comparison, the reset RST functions. Okay, so these are some of the text I obtained from the Mitsubishi manual. What we will be using is FX1 and PLC. It has got 256 counters. So C is the notation for counter. C is the notation for counter. Okay. So C0 to C15 is of 16 bit type. C16 to 199, 16 bit latched. It goes up to 255. So 0 to 255, 256 counters are there. So in your program, you can write a maximum of 3000 counters. Okay. This kind of thing is not possible in Arduino, even I could say. So again and again and again, I'm telling you that PLC may be a bit old, but it is most powerful even as on date 2020. Okay. So we'll be using one C0 now for our example. Then the inline comparison is also very beautiful. So this is the statement. This is the in the ladder logic. If you use greater than symbol, the D0, K0, you know, D0 is a variable actually. A value, constant value stored in a variable. Okay, a data. Okay, so here you can use in place of D0, you can use K also, right? If you hear what it is used, the less than symbol is used. So there are 6 possibilities. If you use this symbol, it is testing as greater than. If the greater than is true, this will be executed. If it is not true, this line will not be executed. That is the idea. If say D0 is equal to K10, use this symbol. Less than means this one. Less than or equal to, not equal to, less than or equal to. Okay. So something like that. Then set reset buttons. You can, instead of getting any instruction from the ladder, you can directly set a particular output to on or particular output to off. Say in this command, so set Y0 means the Y0 is set to on. So Y0 is set to on. In this command, reset Y0. You will say X1 is pressed, Y0 is reset to, Y0 is reset to off. That is the idea. Okay, don't look at this one. Okay, look at this. See, even I know only some amount of information only. With that information, I developed a lot. Okay, so if it is clear, learn it. Otherwise, leave it. You do some small programs. After some time, whatever you are not able to understand now today, it will be understandable after some time. Okay, now we'll write a program is written already. Okay, then one more thing I introduced here. X0, you see, previously we used this symbol. Now, there is a open contact. It is called high raise contact actually. Raising pulse contact. You make a note of this also. Again, let me tell you the difference between a normally open and raising contact. Normally open, take for example, you are pressing a calling bell. You press and hold it for, you will be pressing and holding it for some time. That means the calling bell is pressed and it is held on. So the bell will be ringing till you depress the button, till you release the button. That is normally open type. In place of that normally open type signal, if you use the rising pulse, even though if you press and hold for some time, the very first signal, the rising point, you know, that signal alone is obtained. Even though if you are pressing for a long time, that will not be in effect. That is the meaning of this particular rising pulse. Again, the program written here, I'll give you the program also as a screenshot. It is available as a PDF file, given as a link in the description. You can download it. Also, I'll be giving you these things also, right? So the logic is, say, initially everything is at zero. C0 is, this is the counter. Count C0 is the counter. It will be, I'll be counting it for 4 times. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, here for the K, 1 is the starting letter. For timer, input, output, X, Y, C, M, all, the 0 is the starting digit. Okay, now let me say I am pressing once. So C0 becomes, that is in C0, the K becomes 1 now. Now we test. Okay. If C0 value is 1 now, C0 is 1 now because you pressed once. If C0 is equal to, this is a K means constant. If K is 1, if this condition is true, Y0 is on. Yes, this condition is true actually because you pressed only once. Okay. What about this condition? If C0 is K2, it is not K2 now because you pressed only once. So this is not true. This is not true. That means Y0 alone will be on, Y1, Y2 will be off. Okay. C0 will be complete and on only it reaches number 4. That means this is also not true. The present value of C0 is 1, not the 4. So this will not be executed. Okay, now you pressed and released once. Now again you are pressing this button second time and releasing. That means now C0, previously it was 1, now it is 2. That means this value is C0 value is 2. So this is not true. This is true. C0 is 2, so K2 is 2, 2 equal to 2, so Y0 is on. So only this line is true. So Y0 is not on, it is off. Y1 is on, Y2 is off. This is also not executed. Okay. Now, that time you press C0 3, it becomes 3. So it is not true. Y0 off, not true. Y1 off, it is true. Y2 on. Okay. Now, fourth time you are pressing, then C0 is triggered. C0 is triggered because it reaches K4. So this 3 is not true. This is true. So again, it reset the counter to 0. Okay, counter C0 is reset, so the K becomes actually supposed to be K becomes 0 actually. It has start from 1, right? Now shall we see the ladder logic test? A physical connection is not required. Okay, you can test it here itself. Now the simulation is on. Let me keep it somewhere. Alt 1 or the right click device test or Alt 1. Let me keep it somewhere. You see C0 is 0, C0 is 0, C0 is 0, C0 is 0. Okay. So now let me on X0 once and I off, switch off, switch on and switch off. Now you see, now X0 is pressed once, so counter start counting. Now it is 1. Now this statement is true because C0 is 1, it is equal to K1. So Y0 is on. These two statements are not true, so that is not on. Right? So now it is pressed once. Let me press second time I'm pressing, I'm switching off. So second time I pressed, C0 counter start counting to 2. So this statement is not 2. C0 is 2, it is not equal to K1, it is not equal to 1, but it is equal to 2. So Y1 is on, Y0, Y2 are off. Third time, these two are false, this is true. So this is on. So C3 is 0. C0 is 3. Now fourth time if I press, then what will happen is this is complete. The C0 is sent with K4. Once it has reached K4 the fourth time, so this will be C0 will be activated. Once C0 is activated, that will reset the counter again back to 0. Now you see, fourth time I pressed, now it is reset. This statement is invoked. I hope you understood this particular concept. Okay, so you can add any number actually. You can, K4 can be even 1000, 2000, it can go up to 16 bit, 2 power 16. 2 power 10 means 1024, 2 power 11, say 1024, it will be 1000. 11 means 2000, 12, 4000. And maybe 16,000 bit, 16,000 value you can go, right? Let me exit. So that ends the layout logic test. Let me copy this one. I copied this program, I'll be pasting here. Whatever is understandable, you please try to understand, otherwise I'll leave it as such. After some time you'll get to know. Ladder program is also available here. Okay, so this entire thing will be available to you as a PDF file under the link provided in the description. Okay, thank you. If you like this particular session, you please subscribe it and tell this information to your friends also, so that they'll also get some benefit. They can also learn the Arduino, not only the PLC. So I'll be conducting a parallel sessions, three different things on three different titles: SolidWorks, PLC and Arduino. Okay, so subscribe it, you will learn more. Thank you.